And Mark Spector just sending this out, saying a source confirmed to Sportsnet.ca that Brian Burke was unwilling to make the trade that all of his lieutenants inside the Leafs organization were pushing for. That includes Burke's replacement, new Leafs general manager Dave Nonis, who will now work towards consummating that trade with the Vancouver Canucks. So the trade that was supposed to save Brian Burke's job ends up costing him because he didn't want to make it. That's the hardest evidence that I've heard amid all the speculation, that it comes down to not personality as much as we thought, not record as much as everybody was led to believe, but he wouldn't pull the trigger on the Roberto Luongo trade.
I'm not buying it. I think, as I've said, and I'll maintain it, is that, yes, it had a factor in it, and yes, it may have put it over the top, but I'm not buying for a minute it was all peaches and cream prior to this decision being made. And I guess I'm a little caught off guard that all Brian's lieutenants all of a sudden were on board with this deal. That's not how Brian Burke's group operates. Brian Burke's group, Dave Nonis included, I understand you get into a meeting and you battle for what you believe in. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, it's a group decision, and you stay as a group. And if I hear lieutenants are backstabbing them now...
Nobody's saying backstabbing.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Nobody's saying backstabbing.
Disagreed.
It's just they wanted to make the trade, and Brian Burke was unwilling to.
And that's out.
Or he was...
And we know that's out.
Or he was unwilling as long as the price was so high. And that's the key here.
That's fair.
That's the key. We're not saying that he didn't want it. What I am led to believe is that he thinks the price is too high. And whatever it is it a Kadri plus? Is it Gardner?
Guys.
Listen, Vancouver could ask for Jake Gardner.
You think the price was too high and it wasn't Brian Burke's principles on long-term contracts, a deal that has 10 years left on it?
This is all about leadership style. This is all about personality, leadership style, and this put it over the edge.
This was the
Luongo was not the reason Brian Burke was fired.
The cherry on top.
Exactly. It may have been the final straw, but not the only straw.
Exactly. If Brian Burke makes the Luongo trade, does he still have his job?
He still has his job, and then he would be judged on how successful the team is. Because I guarantee you there was issues before the Luongo name ever came out.
And if it's the mandate to get Luongo, let's see what Dave Nonis pays for him, okay?
Well, the price should be higher now, right?
That'll be a new one.
Mike Gillis?
Right.
Unless it's been agreed to.
He's in an easy chair right now if the deal hasn't already been made. Because what can you ask for under all this pressure now? And all these stories coming out of Toronto on how the cherry on top was the Luongo trade.
Roberto Luongo skating in Florida, about to head to Canada. Which city is he going to go? Tony Ambrosio actually caught up with him this morning, just minutes before the Brian Burke news broke.
Roberto, this is your last day in Florida, so the magic question is, where is your ticket, your plane ticket, bound to?
I'm going back to beautiful Vancouver tomorrow.
How excited are you about finally... all the talk, all the speculation, just getting out on the ice with your Vancouver Canucks teammates?
I'm really excited. I think that's one of the things I've missed the most since the beginning of the lockout, being around the guys and joking around, playing some hockey games, and especially, miss the competition.
Now, have you had a chance to talk to them much at all before you head out there?
Yeah, I've spoken to a couple guys. I've been talking to Schneids yesterday a little bit, so... I think we're all just in the same boat, excited to get back to work and looking forward to playing some hockey again.
Now, before you left this workout today, Peter Warrell almost caused a huge incident when he took a puck, hit you in the right hand. You were down for a bit, but just to give us the update, how are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm okay. I just got dinged up a little bit, caught me on the tip of my finger, so just a little bruise, but I was able to finish practice, and it was scarier than anything else.
I was going to ask you, was there a thought in your mind going, oh, this can't be at this time?
Well, at first, you don't know what's going on, So, once it settled down a little bit, I was able to move it around. I was quite relieved, and, it would have been pretty bad timing for me to get injured at this point.
With camp almost here, have you thought at all about concerns, if any, that you might be a distraction when you get to Vancouver, or do you not allow that to get in your mind?
Well, I'm just going to be there... Do what I do all the time. Let's work hard. Be a good teammate and do whatever I can to help the team. So obviously, I'm sure there's going to be distractions coming from the outside. But, you know, I think we got a good core group of guys there that we're not going to let that affect what happens inside the locker room.
A couple last ones. Have you had a chance to talk to Mike Gillis in recent days at all for an update there?
I haven't. I know that, you know, he wanted to wait till the labor deal was ratified before we move on some things. And I'm sure when he has some news, he'll let me know.
Last one for you. Some reporters are calling a provision in the CBA with regards to lengthy contracts the Luongo rule. When you hear that, kind of what goes through your mind?
I'm not sure how I feel about it. You know, at the end of the day, really, even though it's called the Luongo rule, I mean, all I do is play hockey. So, you know, I want to play hockey as long as I can, you know, as long as I'm enjoying the game. So, you know, hopefully that rule won't have to take place in my circumstance. But, it's kind of funny when you see something like that.
And just a final one for you. With Twitter, rumor, speculation, constant for months now, how have you not allowed it to bother you?
I don't know. I guess, you know, you just kind of take it for what it is and you let it roll off your back. I mean, it's hockey. It's a game. You know, things happen. And, you know, there are more serious things in life. And you want to, you know, try to take it in a positive way, the best way you can, and move forward.
Roberto, thank you so much. Best of luck in your travels and in your hockey future.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
You watch that workout. It's the all white equipment. It's very generic. So he's ready to go wherever he's going to go.
Only another goalie.
No, it's true though. I mean, the mask is still a Vancouver Canucks, but Roberto Luongo feels like he's ready to move on. That's the indication I get from him.
Yes. And we've experienced Luongo on a couple occasions, and at times he could be very standoffish with the media. But this may be an instant when, you know, he's out there right now and he doesn't know where his future is. And then, you know, to be a little bit more media friendly or savvy could help him right now.
And he's somewhat in control of his destiny. He knows he's got, you know, he can go back to Vancouver and whatever unfolds there unfolds. But if he moves, he can control ultimately where he ends up going.
Except.
To a degree.
Except the asking price and the contract takes away
destination.
Controlling your own destiny is a misnomer when you've got that contract and you've also got that term.
And that's why he's not a Florida Panther.
And that's why he's a nicer guy today.
And Florida wants him. They're in this mix here. They believe that they're in this mix. They want to be in this mix. They're in dire need of a guy that they can hang their hat on and rebuild that that franchise. People argue to this day that he's still the most popular Florida Panther to ever play. And
but they do have Markstrom coming.
But they're not. So. They're not willing to pay Mike Gillis's price.
Here's John Garrett speaking with us on the telephone on this special on Hockey Central on Sportsnet. The firing of Brian Burke. Also, rumors revolving around Roberto Luongo and Burke's dismissal comes, according to Mark Spector, that Brian Burke would not pull the trigger on the Luongo trade. Right now, Roberto, John, is headed to Vancouver for training camp. How much of a distraction is that going to be?
I don't think it will be. I don't think it'll be a distraction other than it's Corey Schneider is the number one guy, but it puts more pressure on him. And I think that just between the two goaltenders, that's where the conflict is going to be, and it's never a comfortable thing. The other players, the 48-game schedule, you'll have a week-long training camp. The other players, and Nick, you know this, that when you're a player, you concentrate on your own position. You concentrate on the other right wingers who are trying to take your job, or the other defensemen if you're the sixth or seventh guy. You don't worry about what's happening in the goaltending department. So I don't think that would really be a distraction. But it's uncomfortable for both the goaltenders, and the Roberto situation gets so much press out here that I think the fans and everybody else, it's a distraction for them.
Well, you mentioned that, John, but give me a scenario where they go 1-4. You still feel the same way?
If they go 1-4 and Corey Schneider plays all five games, I really don't think that's going to happen. I think Corey has earned the chance, and I think Corey will do well. The Canucks are, people tend to forget, they just look at that exit from the playoffs last year. You have to remember, they've back-to-back President's Trophy winners, 4 years in a row, 100 points, and basically the same team, except you add Jason Garrison to the blue line. So I think the Canucks will be a good team, and the goaltender's not going to have to be great. He's just going to have to be good. I think Roberto is the guy that he doesn't want to be a backup goaltender. He wants to still be the number one guy. He always has been, and you were talking about Florida. He was great there, and if a team is desperate to make the playoffs, like the Leafs are, I think Roberto's the guy. He will get you in the playoffs. Now, 48-game season, you look at his track record, he can play 40 to 45 games. Played more games than any other goalie other than Marty Brodeur.
So, John, I was going to ask that question, but you answered like three in a row there. So I know you're a Luongo fan, and, I mean, my question was going to be, is he the right guy for the Toronto Maple Leafs? And why, in fact, would Brian Burke be so adamant against this deal, if, in fact, that's true? When you just said it as a goaltending guru, that he's the guy that can get you in the playoffs.
Well, you look at Roberto Luongo and why he's out here in Vancouver. It's not the regular season, and it's not those times during the regular season where he would have a little hiccup, but it was always just a little hiccup. It's the playoffs, and he had his chance in the playoffs. He had four cracks at it in the playoffs, and he just couldn't get it done in the playoffs, so you have to make that decision. And the Canucks made that last year during the playoffs, that they were going to go with Corey Schneider. So a team like Toronto hasn't made the playoffs since the last lockout. You want to make the playoffs, you go out and get a guy who can do that for you, and that's Roberto Luongo. And I know, Doug, you think that maybe that's why Brian Burke, he was let go, and the timing is so weird. You just think, why now? But to me, they haven't made the playoffs since the last lockout. So, and look at the deals that Brian has made, and there's been some mistakes along the way, and there was rumors that he was going to get it at the end of the last season, and that's probably when it should have happened and not now. But I don't think it's just because he wouldn't pull the trigger on the Luongo thing.
You take Roberto Luongo.
By the way, I want to clarify, John, I didn't think that was the only reason. It was obviously something that put somebody over the ledge.
You take Roberto Luongo in his prime. How close is he in his game right now to that level?
Oh, I think he's still there. He's one of the best conditioned athletes on the team. He works hard at his trade. You watch him practice, and he's another one of those goalies that he tries to stop every shot in practice, and he's still there. He's 33 years old. He's played a lot of hockey. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
But playing with the Canucks, he's played on a pretty good team these last 5 or 6 years, and it's not as hard on a goaltender when your team is scoring a lot of goals. And you look at the Canucks, they had the most goals in the Western Conference last year. They had the most goals in the NHL the year before. And that takes some of the pressure off, too.
Okay, John, so if he's still as good as you think he is, why is the Stanley Cup contending team getting rid of him? What's wrong with him? Why are they going with him? What's going on with the guy?
The playoffs, Nick. The playoffs. Like, you get a goaltender that it plays absolutely lights out during the regular season, and you don't get the Vezina Trophy nominations like he did for not playing really well. But the playoffs. And then you decide in your own mind that, okay, he's got a mental block when it comes to the playoffs. And you go to Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final, and you still think that he's got that mental block. Well, you look at the games in Boston. He gets a shutout in Game 5 in Vancouver, a 1-0 game. He was absolutely great. And then he goes in a game where they really needed him in Boston, and he stunk the joint out. And so it's the mental part of the playoffs that I think that's why
pressure.
The Canucks have said, okay, we'll go with Corey Schneider.
What is Schneider's playoff record?
Well, I know, but you got to make the switch. He's done it. He did it in the minors. He played really well, and he played well for the Canucks, so he's earned the chance to give it a try.
He's cheaper.
To make the change.
Is the Roberto Luongo scenario in Vancouver as he heads back there for training camp, is it in any way salvageable?
I think they can coexist. I don't think there's a problem there other than for Roberto Luongo. He wants to be the number one guy, and in a 48-game season, he's not going to get the chance to play every third or fourth game and that's what your backup play once every fifth game. He's not going to get that opportunity, and I think Roberto is going to get to the point where he is going to want out. I think he wants out now.
And it's too expensive for Vancouver.
Yeah.
For this year, what are you going to do? For this year, if the right deal doesn't come along, you have to take both of them. And
if they're both there.
With the cap the way it is right now, they're all right.
If they're both there on January 19th, who gets the start?
Oh, Corey Schneider.
He does?
Corey Schneider gets the first five starts.
John, good catching up with you. Have a good day.
It's always nice talking to you guys, too.
Thanks, John.
We need to get
after
a new picture.
The dip, anyway. So.
There's John Garrett.
Looks like he was dipped in flour.
No, there's something red on the top with a cherry on top.
With all due respect to John, I find this kind of a contradictory explanation of you want the guy, you're troubled by his playoff performances, and yet you did get the Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final. And I don't think they lost because of one guy.
And he won an Olympic gold medal.
And he won an Olympic gold.